The Ball Orchestra's Party. Hello, everyone. What are you up to today? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt. Of course, it's the Ball Orchestra. What a wonderful visit. Oh my.
Party?
I don't know, Pocoyo. Maybe they're going to use the radio to play music. Oh. Maybe not.
Orchestra?
Me all alone. Wait! Welcome to Pocoyo World Radio. The Ball Orchestra has invited you to their party, but to find it, you must first figure out some clues. We'll keep you posted. I don't know, Pato. Perhaps the party is back there. You could have a look. Breaking news! It seems that Pato has found the key to locate the party. Bravo! You have solved the first puzzle. This has been our broadcast for today. Stay tuned for more. You're right, Pato. Where is your musical note?
There, Pato!
Cheer up, Pato. Remember, we're going to a party.
Party!
Well done! Great tune, Pocoyo. Come on, Ellie, make a start. And one, and two, and three, and... That's it, Pato. Shake those feathers. Look, you found another portal. Very good. You're getting closer to the party. Hey, guys. Hey, everyone. Shh. Do you hear that? Yes, it's the trumpet ball. The party must be very close by. Come on, we have to find it. Hello, Fred.
Party?
Pocoyo is wondering if you know how to get to the Ball Orchestra's party. Great. Which way is it?
I didn't get that either. Fred, are you sure? There should be only one way to get to a party. Oh, dear. It's working, Pocoyo. Keep playing, keep playing. You solved the last puzzle. Hooray for friends, and hooray for parties full of music and rhythm. Goodbye, see you soon. But Pocoyo didn't like how they played, and didn't want any of his friends in the band.
A Halloween special with Pocoyo and friends.
Look, it's Pato and Pocoyo. Hello. What are you doing here?
Trick-or-treat.
Oh, I see. You're going trick-or-treating, and you're going into that eerie house to get some candy. Pato, Pocoyo is right. If you want candy, you have to be brave. That's it. Very brave, Pato. Wow, that's very, homey. So now what shall we do?
Trick or treat!
Okay, let's go in and get some candy. Pato's right, I think. Maybe we should go back where we came from and...
Scary.
Are you saying that we're scared? Well done, Pato. Very daring. Now, get one of those candies and let's get out of here. That's creepy. Maybe we'd better take a look around. Pato, go upstairs. Pato also thinks it's better to take a look upstairs.
Thank you.
What's that? Oh, wow. It's a crow. Oh, this is so spooky.
Baby Bird.
Oh, so it was Baby Bird. You see, Pardo, there's nothing to be afraid of. Looks like Pato wants to go on his own. Come on, Pato. Don't get angry. It's Halloween. It's normal to get a couple of frights. Especially in such a creepy house as this. What's up, Pato? Oh. It's a lift, and there's someone inside. Oh, it's Ellie, Nina, Lula, and Roberto. Oh, Pato. Pato, wait, where are you going? Pato, let me explain. Oh no, it's a ghost! Pato, calm down. I'm sure there must be an explanation for all this. Yes, take a bath and relax. That's it. A hot tub will help. Oh, Fred, it was you. Pato, wait! Oh no, not the ghost again. It's Sleepy Bird.
Sleepy Bird!
You see, Pato, it can all be easily explained. It was all our friends dressed up. Pato! Pato! Behind you! It's... It's real ghosts. And they look quite friendly. Experience. Bye-bye. See you soon. Friends. Hello, everyone. Where are you going? Oh, I see. You have tickets to Pocoyo and Nina's Halloween Theater. How exciting! Wonderful.
Everything's ready to raise the curtain for the big show.
Pocoyo, Nina, the audience has arrived. Are you ready? Great. Then let the show begin. Didn't seem to scare them very much. Wow, I'm afraid we have a very tough audience today.
Plan B?
Ah, Pocoyo and Nina have prepared a much more terrifying alternative plan. Nina says that now the true spectacle of horror and fear begins.
Pocoyo!
Thank you.
Pocoyo? That's incredible!
This is really scary.
But who's moving those skeletons?
Nina!
But, Nina, are you the one who's controlling those puppets?
Pocoyo!
Pocoyo? But if it's not Pocoyo, and it's not Nina either, then who's playing Spooky?
Theater group Los Hermanos Chihuahua. Theater, birthday parties, baptisms, and burials. And that's their business card. So this dance show is part of your artistic repertoire. It looks like it's time to leave. The show must go on. But far, far away from here. This adventure has been frightfully terrific. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Oh, blocks. Good day for building up and up. And there are some more blocks. Did you see that? Maybe it was nothing. Okay, I definitely saw something that time. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what happened when he hummed?
The blocks moved!
My goodness, look at those blocks move! Well, I have to say, these are not normal blocks. They really love the music, don't they? These blocks are so funky, they really can move, can't they? And when it goes quiet, they all stop moving again. Oh, what a great idea! Let's see what happens when we play different types of music. rock and roll. Oh, yes. Jazz music. That's my favorite, Pocoyo. Ah, classical music. Such an impressive sound. Pocoyo, Pato is, well... Pocoyo, you need to help get Pato down! He's stuck on top of the blocks! Are you really sure you should be doing that? Do you remember what will happen if the music stops, Pocoyo? Can any of you help, Pocoyo? Do you remember what happens when the music stops?
The blocks fall! They all fall down!
Yes, and if the blocks fall, Pato falls with them! Pocoyo, quick! How can you get up there to save Pato? Of course! The Vamoosh is here to save the day! Pocoyo, bravo! Whoa, that was some adventure. Music certainly is wonderful, isn't it? Hooray for music! And hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon. Pocoyo? What's this? It looks like a... Oh, that's strange. It certainly is a nice bright colour. Can any of you tell what colour it is?
It's red!
That's right! It's red! Oops! It looks like you'll have to catch it first. But that could be difficult. Perhaps it just wants to play, Pocoyo. Now, Pocoyo, it's not as bad as all that. Yes, I understand that you're frustrated, but... Did it just speak? It did speak! Perhaps someone should reply to it.
Me!
You, Pocoyo? Now it's your turn, Pato. That doesn't seem to be working. That's better. Oh my! Where did it go? Do you think it might come back if we all call out, "Where are you?" Good. Ready? Where are you? Once again. Where are you? Could we do better than that, Pocoyo? Once again. Where are you? Yes, Pocoyo. It was right there.
Buddy!
Your new friend is certainly mischievous, Pocoyo. This must be another friend. And another one. How many shapes does that make? Let's count them. One, two, three. Hello, Ellie. It seems your new friend wants to tell you something, Pocoyo. Is that right? The dancing must have given him an idea. I wonder what they're planning. It looks as if they have a surprise in store.
Party.
done! What lovely music! Hooray for Pocoyo! And hooray for finding new ways to play! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hi, Pato. You're looking sharp. Have you got a new job? Oh, I see. You've become an outer space postman. How exciting. And you've got an assistant. Who is this package for, Pato? Ah, to Green Alien. And it's a rush delivery? Well, you'd better get going. You wouldn't want your first package to be delivered late.
And we have liftoff!
According to the address, Green Alien's house should be around here somewhere. Yep, here it is. Pato? I don't think that's him. Oh, I see. He says that Green Alien has moved and he doesn't live here anymore. But he would be happy to give you his new address. Well, according to this new address, Green Alien should be living right here. I'm afraid this is the wrong address. But no worries, the Toridoris know where he is. Looks like there's no one on this planet. I'm so sorry, Mr. Basketball. He says Green Alien's not here either, Pato, but that this is his new address. Green Alien! At last you found him! He's wondering what took you so long. The Vamoosh is out of fuel. Of the sun will take you back home.
Welcome home! Good job! Quite right. Baby Bird deserves some credit too. Hooray for Baby Bird!
Oh my, it certainly is a hot day here in Pocoyo's world. Oh, and look, there's Ellie. Looks like she's trying to keep cool.
Hello, Ellie.
You haven't seen Pocoyo today, have you, Ellie? That's strange. He usually enjoys the heat on a hot day. I know, maybe he's with Pato. I'll see you, Ellie. And there's Pato. I believe Pato is trying to keep cool too. Pato, you haven't seen Pocoyo, have you? Pato, but was that a no or a... sorry, Pato, I still didn't quite catch that. Are you saying... All right. I'll keep looking then. Sorry to have disturbed you, Pato. Now, I wonder where Pocoyo could be. Oh, there you are at last. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Lula.
Hi.
And look, it's Pocoyo's musical flower.
Flower. Music.
Pocoyo just loves his musical flower. Did you know, I believe Pocoyo has the only musical flower in the whole world. Looks like it's empty, Pocoyo.
More music.
Yes, it would be nice to hear more music, wouldn't it? How can you get your flower to play more music if your watering can is empty, Pocoyo? Can any of you help, Pocoyo?
Get more water!
More water!
It seems the water tap has dried up in all this heat as well. At least you've filled up your watering can for your flower.
Flower.
Poor Pato must be terribly thirsty. Oh, Pocoyo, that's very nice of you, giving some of the water to Pato.
Flower!
Oh, I wonder what she's up to. Oh, now I see. Ellie's going to take a nice cool bath to beat the heat. What a good idea. There's nothing an elephant likes better than a nice cool bath. Oh dear, there's no water left. Oh, there goes Ellie's bath, and she was so looking forward to it. Oh, Pocoyo, what a good deed. You certainly made Ellie feel better. But shouldn't we see about your...
flower.
Hmm. Oh, dear. It seems that Pocoyo used up all his water helping his friends. Now there's no water for his flower. Don't worry, Pocoyo. Maybe someone will help you. I think someone might be on their way right now. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who's coming?
I am Pocoyo!
Oh, well, that's very nice, but I think the flower needs more than... Look at that! It seems that when friends help each other, magical things can happen. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hello, Pocoyo. Rocking out with your guitar? Now this is a rock band. Okay, let's take a band photo. Who's the leader?
Me!
Perfect band photo at last. Well done, Ellie. Now everyone will know to come to your show. And Nina's helping too. Good. Good job, Pocoyo. Ah, the night of the big show. It's sold out. Well, at least you still have one fan. Much better! Now this is rock and roll, baby. Bye-bye. Hello, girls. What are you doing? Ellie, Nina, come on now. There must be a dance move that you both like. Now that's dancing! Let's see who else wants to see your cool moves. Thank you. Wait a minute, wait a minute. Roberto? You're all such super dancers. Goodbye.
Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hello.
What do you think that is, Pocoyo? Oh my, that was a surprise. Don't be scared, Pato. It's fun. Look, Pocoyo's going to press another button. Well, how about that? It talks and it makes music. You know what it is, Pocoyo? Pato? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what it's called?
Radio!
It's a radio!
Yes, it's a radio!
Radio!
Wow, Pato, that dance looks really cool. I think Pocoyo would like to try.
Pocoyo dance!
Here's Ellie.
Ellie dance.
Oh, I say, what a beautiful dance, Ellie.
Hello, dance.
What's wrong, Pocoyo? Don't you want to dance? Well then, why don't you? What? You don't know how to dance like Pato? And you don't know how to dance like Ellie either? Is that it? Well, you may not be able to dance like Pato or like Ellie, but I know one person you can certainly dance like. You can dance like Pocoyo. So how about it? Show us the Pocoyo dance. Do any of you want to see Pocoyo's dance? Maybe you should let him know that you'd like to see him dance. Go ahead. Tell Pocoyo you want to see him dance.
Please dance, Pocoyo.
We want to.
What fun! And now let's all dance. Everybody, get up and dance. So many different ways to dance. Everyone can have a go. Hooray for dancing and for Pocoyo. Bye-bye. See you soon. Look, it's Caterpillar. Hello, Caterpillar. Where are you off to? Ah, hello, everyone. Hello? Hello? Oh, honestly, my goodness, we are all in a silly mood today. What's all the excitement about?
Talent show!
Ah, you're doing a talent show? How exciting! So, who goes first? Ah, Ellie. Wonderful. Ellie is performing ballet karate for the show. Smashing! Let's all clap for Ellie. Oh, so you're next, baby bird. You say you made this yourself, baby bird. And you are totally crazy. Well, off you go then. Whoa, and extra points too! What a surprising talent! Everything okay, Caterpillar?
Next!
Yes, yes, on with the show!
Whale!
Whale is next, but, where is Whale?
Whale?
That was lovely, Whale. Let's all clap for Whale. It seems Pato is going to do some acting for us. He's going to pretend to be things. Interesting. A ping pong table. Well played, Pato. Flowers. How beautiful. A fan. Now that's cool. A swing. Fantastic. Oh, you want us to guess what you're being next? All right. What do you think Pato is pretending to be?
A clock!
Pato's a clock!
Wow, Pato's been a clock!
Oh, you know, I think you're right. Yes, a clock! One last one. All right, here comes the big finish. Wow! A car driving along a road! Brilliant! Let's clap for Pato.
Well done, Pato! Yay! That was amazing!
Caterpillar, your turn. Oh, I think Caterpillar wants you to go first, Pocoyo, if you don't mind.
Okay.
You want me to read that, Pocoyo? You've written a story? Once upon a time, there was a very tiny mosquito.
Tiny mosquito!
Who lived in a huge castle.
Enormous castle!
But he felt very lonely in his huge castle.
I feel so lonely!
Suddenly, he had an idea. He decided to throw a party.
Party!
He invited his friend Pablo. He invited Marcus, the van. And Martha, the mountain. So the mosquito took his motorcycle to find his friends and... It fell over! But it was okay because he had a helmet on. The end. Wow! Well, let's all clap! Caterpillar, where are you going? It's your turn now. She's flying away. Come on, Caterpillar. Give it a try. You'll be brilliant. And anyway, it's for fun. Let's all encourage Caterpillar to give it a go.
Try it, Caterpillar!
We want to see what you can do.
Okay, show us your talent.
Hippopotamus.
Hippopotamus. Well, sounds great! Oh, really? Caterpillar says that hippopotamuses are very large herbivorous mammals who live chiefly in sub-Saharan Africa. It's fascinating. Oh, and they spend most of the day in the water, subsisting on a diet of aquatic plants, but at night they travel onto the land to graze. Oh, well, how about that? Hip, hip, hooray! Everybody, let's clap for Caterpillar and for all these amazing talents.
Yay!
Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hi, Pocoyo! Hi, Nina!
Hey!
Oh, gee, I'm sorry. Hi, Lula! No, Pocoyo. Lula's not dancing. She's scratching. But why? Ah, Nina, you know what the problem is? Oh, you've got fleas. That's why you're scratching yourself. What can we do about it?
flea party! Their dancing is making Lula itchy, and so she has to scratch herself. Made the fleas massage Lula instead of making her itchy. Congratulations, guys! Yeah. Everyone gets a massage, and the fleas can dance as much as they want.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Yes, I heard it too. Oh, it's your foot.
Feet.
I wonder what's in that box. Perhaps you should look inside. It looks like a whistle. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what you do with a whistle?
Blow it!
Blow it!
That's right! You blow it! Well, that wasn't a whistle sound. Hello, Pato. Looking for something? Pocoyo, did you notice that when you blow that whistle, Pato thinks that someone is calling him?
Hello.
Look, Pocoyo, your whistle has got Pato out of the shower. Well, Pocoyo, now we've all seen that the whistle calls Pato, don't you think we should put it away? Now, Pocoyo, we know it's fun for you, but I think... Well, I think you might be making Pato a little cross. That's a very different sound. Can any of you tell me who that sound is calling?
Ellie!
Pato, you didn't like it when Pocoyo did that to you. Do you think it's right? Now, Ellie, are you going to be part of this too? Can any of you tell me who that sound might call?
Lula!
That's right! It's Lula!
Pocoyo!
That wasn't me, I'm afraid.
Pocoyo! Pocoyo!
Oh dear, I don't think this is solving anything. Oh, Baby Bird is upset that you are all so cross with each other. Is this game really all that much fun for anyone?
No more!
Pato, now, Pato! Oh, maybe you shouldn't do that, Baby Bird. That's how all the trouble began. What a pleasant surprise! Hooray for making friends again. Bye-bye. See you soon.